Well, very good afternoon. For those of you who don't know me, I'm Geoff Leask, Chief Executive at Young Enterprise Scotland. And to the left of me on my screen, and maybe to the right of you on your screen, I'm not very sure, is Fraser Morrison, Company Programme and Digital Delivery Manager at Young Enterprise Scotland. Thank you very much indeed for joining us on this Thursday afternoon. It's a delight to have you here with us this evening to our Southwest Regional Improvement Collaborative session. And just a quick word of housekeeping on the screen. If you have any questions, please feel free to post them in the sidebar. And what we propose we'll do is we will answer them all collectively towards the end of tonight's entertainment. This is the live on the television as we speak. So let me take you back to the television years of 1992. In 1992, it was the year John Major was elected as the UK Prime Minister. It was the year of Black Wednesday, if you can remember that. Back then, it was also when on a Friday evening, the shop of choice was Blockbuster Video Rental, and off you went and rented your new release along with your popcorn. And if you had to get there by car and you needed to put some petrol in your Ford Fiesta that night, then it would cost you a huge sum of 46 pence a litre back in 1992. How times have changed. Anyway, why all of the information about 1992? Because as you'll see on the screen, the mathematicians amongst you will recognise that Young Enterprise Scotland was founded in 1992. And if you do the sums, then you'll find out that's our 30th anniversary. So for 30 years, Young Enterprise Scotland has been working to inspire and equip young people to learn and succeed through enterprise. And now as the organisation grows, through financial education also. But since that time, in 1992, Young Enterprise Scotland, like any other business, although we're a charity, we operate like a business. We have reacted and evolved according to the market within which we operate. And today, as well as the company and team program, which we're going to share a lot more with you about this evening, we have grown into many other areas. And just thinking about the company program, it was actually first delivered in the UK in 1963. So next year's a big anniversary. That'll be 60 years since it was first delivered in the UK. And then it came to Scotland in 1971. And then the charity that now delivers that programme, Young Enterprise Scotland, was formed in 1992. And I wish we had, I'm sure Fraser does too, we had all the names and addresses of everybody who had participated in that company programme, because it must be way into six figures, I would imagine, in the hundreds of thousands of young people who have benefited from the company programme over the years. Anyway, today, Young Enterprise Scotland is far more than the company programme, and we have activity that works its way through, and we're going to hear more about some of these programs here just now. So if we give you a few examples of where Young Enterprise Scotland has enhanced its reach, probably up the ladder and down the ladder, we now work in primary schools. In primary schools, we deliver the Fiverr Challenge, for example, where we give young people from primary £5 to start a business. Not a lot of money, but it's amazing what young people can do with a fiver. And then reacting to the changing world in which we live, we have the Circular Economy Challenge that was developed a few years ago to enable young people to learn more about a circular economy whilst also developing enterprise skills. We have Bridge to Business, which operates in the college sector. And as we're in the Southwest tonight, I'm delighted to say that six or seven young people from Dumfries and Galloway College will depart these shores on Saturday for a two-week enterprise learning journey to Barcelona. And I would imagine it's a bit warmer there than it is here in at Glasgow this evening. And finally, we also are at our centre at Rooking Glen. We're just about to open an enterprise village where we'll actually have physical space for young people to set up their own little enterprise here when they leave school or college. But we today, in May 2022, we stand at a unique and very exciting point in time. For those aficionados of government strategies, you will have noticed that there's been a recent launch of a fresh and exciting national strategy for economic transformation. We'll abbreviate that, as governments do, to the NSET. And the aim of that strategy is to establish Scotland as a world-class entrepreneurial nation that is founded on a culture that encourages, promotes and celebrates entrepreneurial activity in every sector of our country. And it's also going to promote the best available project-based entrepreneurial learning across the school and post-education curricula. So that's what we do already. So we have a huge part to play in that. And also entrepreneurship into the Young Person's Guarantee. And we'll all know about the Young Person's Guarantee, where every young person has the right to an apprenticeship, a volunteer experience, a job. And now they will have that right to participate in enterprise. And that embedding of entrepreneurship in the Young Person's Guarantee will help us to cultivate the business leaders of tomorrow by really exposing them to first-rate enterprise activities. So let me take you back to that NSET ambition to ensure that Scotland is a world-class entrepreneurial nation founded on a culture that encourages, promotes, celebrates entrepreneurial activity in every sector. I know we can do it. And let me tell you a quick story before I hand over to Fraser. And as we're in the southwest, I remember being in a hotel in Kilmarnock. And I remember a particular presentation by young people who had participated in our company program that evening. And the reason I was struck by that presentation was it was delivered by only two in the company. And as many people who know the company program, it can be, we sometimes see 10, 12, 15 young people. There's only two. And they had never produced a product. They never got there. They never sold a product, therefore. But they wanted to participate in that showcase event that evening to tell their story. And the fact that they didn't produce a product or sell a product was not a negative to them. It was about the impact that the program had, the skills that they developed and learned, and they participated that evening and won. I think they won the best presentation. So it's not all about who sells the most. It's not all about who makes the most. The company program that I'm just going to hand over to Fraser to tell you a bit more about, it's about the skills that these young people develop, and that's why we will a huge part in the national strategy for economic transformation. Anyway, that's enough for me at the moment. I'll be back soon, but I'm passing you over to Fraser Morrison in the studio.
Thanks very much, Geoff, and thanks for that great introduction to a bit of the context around why we're here tonight to talk all about the future of enterprise education and how we can help you in the schools all across the southwest to help embed that into the curriculum and your timetables. So our two flagship programmes that we're really here to talk about tonight are the company and team programme. As Geoff said, it's what we've been delivering here as our main programme for the last 30 years and beyond in Scotland. And the company programme, what makes it so different is it is a real practical enterprise experience. At Young Enterprise Scotland, we are all about learning by doing and giving those young people the opportunity to put into practice the skills that they're developing. The company programme is designed for students in S5 and S6 all across the country. And we actually currently operate all the way from Orkney and Shetland down to the borders and the Bruce and Galloway and every local authority in between. And we're keen to expand the number of schools we're working with in this region. The company programme, though, is not what people might assume is a business builder looking to create and churn out a number of businesses every year. That's not what we're here for. The company programme is all about skills development. We want to make sure that the young people that come through our programme are able to develop, enhance and understand those key enterprise and employability skills so that they can take those in whatever they choose to do after the company programme. And I'm always so impressed every year to talk with alumni of the programme that talk just so passionately about what an impact that has had on their lives. The young people do everything as part of that business on the company programme, from setting up their board of directors, deciding on job roles, generating an idea, going out and doing market research, marketing that product, creating production of that product or service, launching it, going out and selling it across their region and indeed online with worldwide sales, and then taking part in a competition. Because the company programme here is actually a worldwide competition that students are taking part in. Young Enterprise Scotland is very proud to be a member of JA Worldwide, which stands for Junior Achievement Worldwide. And there are 150 countries where the company programme runs. And the young people here tonight in the Southwest will have the opportunity to compete as part of their local region, which will go on to represent the region at the Scottish Finals this year on the 1st of June. And we really hope you'll be able to join us for that online session at 7 o'clock on Wednesday, the 1st of June, on our YouTube channel, where you can see this year's 15 finalists from all across Scotland compete for to be crowned the Scottish Company of the Year. Somebody will go on to represent Scotland at the UK Finals in the middle of June and could go on to represent the UK at the Europeans and then Europe at the Worldwide Finals in August. So there really is an opportunity here to be a global thinkers and global entrepreneurs starting here at that school level. Now, what's really important in a recent addition over the last 3 years is the company programme is now an accredited qualification in Scotland, and it's a level 6 on the SCQF worth 26 to 30 credit points, recognised by UCAS on the UCAS tariff system and also recognised on Insight as well. And that's an important one for schools. And why that's so important is it means that the young people who are putting in so much of their time and effort every single week over the course of a full academic year are getting the recognition for all of their time that they spend, all of the skills that they're developing and all of the work that they're putting in to create this business. Now, we also have the team programme. Now, the team programme is very similar to the company programme. They work over the course of an academic year. They work with a business advisor who comes in on a weekly basis to help develop their skills. And it's specifically designed for students aged 15 and above with additional support needs. And it's a different range of resources, more support available from the teaching staff that work with the students. But again, that's a UK-wide competition that those students are getting to take part in. And crucially, there's also a qualification, an SCQF Level 3, worth 15 credit points available for that programme. And that means that any young person in Scotland, regardless of where they're situated, whether that be in a mainstream school setting, within an inclusion unit, or even in settings out with that kind of formal education setting, we work with a number of groups. I mean, at the moment, we're having conversations in the Southwest with charitable organisations who are working with young people out with the school day to look at how the team programme can be embedded as part of a framework for their skills development. So there's lots of opportunities that we're really keen and happy to talk about how the company and team programme can be developed and embedded right across the Southwest so that young people, regardless of their background or regardless of where they're situated, get access to some of that key knowledge and key enterprise skills. But I know I can certainly talk till I'm blue in the face about the company programme, because I myself am an alumni of the programme back in 2014, 8 years ago when I took part in my sixth year at school. And that's why I'm so passionate about being able to say, actually, it may sound cliche, but this programme really can change young people's lives. and can change the trajectory of what they believe is possible. And that's the beauty of enterprise, because it gives young people the opportunity to see there's a much wider world out there for what is possible post-school. And instead of just me talking about the benefits of the programme, we've actually asked one of the winners of this year's regional finals from the Southwest to prepare a short presentation. Now, unfortunately, they can't be with us tonight because they all have a very big maths exam tomorrow morning, but they've decided to pre-record that instead. And so we're going to hear in just a moment from Coastal Creatives, who are this year's Dumfries and Galloway regional finalists from Stranraer Academy. And they're going to tell you a little bit about their business. So I hope you enjoy this very short video that tells a little bit about their story.
Coastal Creatives, and welcome to our presentation. We here at Coastal Creatives specialise in handmade craft kits for kids, which both help encourage creativity and promote positive family values.
Social media played an important role in advertising our products and raising awareness of our company's goals, and acted as a vessel for our mission statement. We took advantage of platforms such as Facebook, Instagram and Snapchat and made regular posts on updates and progress, as well as a way of marketing finished products that were ready for sale. Arguably, our most successful venture into social media was on Facebook, where we gathered a large following of over 200 people as of March this year, and it's still growing, averaging about 2,000 interactions per post. We often shared our posts in local groups where we gained considerable attention from consumers. As well as this, we used polls and often interacted with our followers to provide a quality customer service to ensure a happy and satisfied consumer base, often sharing with us what their experiences were with the products.
Making the product was not an expensive job. Costing only £1.51 for each individual pack, we went ahead and took advantage of psychological pricing to persuade our consumers into thinking they were receiving a great deal for the craft kits. This results in us earning an £8.48 profit per pack. Although it did cost an estimate of £160 for one production, it did produce 65 craft kits, which would give us a return of around £650, £550 profit.
Throughout the course of creating our products and expanding our business, I took the role in ensuring that we had the ability to sell our produce in an ideal location where we would manage to hit our target market when it was at its peak. With the help of both St Joseph's and Belmont Primary Schools, we managed to have customers order and pick up their item of choice from Stranraer Academy. Around December time, we also hosted an event within the school. During this time, we would set up a booth at lunchtime where we managed to have pupils buy and decorate their own Christmas figurines. We have also managed to sell our products within local businesses within Stranraer, such as the Fig and Olive.
That's all for our presentation. Thank you for watching.
Well, what a fantastic presentation there that was from Coastal Creatives. Loving to see the creativity that they all put into pulling that all together. Now, we've looked at the past 30 years, we've looked a little bit at the programme, we've looked at some of our present people telling their story, and now it's about looking forward into the future of how we can help you embed enterprise education within the Southwest. So I'm going to hand over to Geoff to tell you a little bit more about that.
Thank you very much indeed, Fraser. And I can only endorse what you say there about Coastal Creations. It's a wonderful, wonderful video, and I'm just wondering how they do that. How do you place yourself into a comic book technology with young people at the core of it? So fantastic stuff. And I think they're in the final of the company program on the 1st of June, and we look forward to seeing how they do. and also the Ayrshire Company of the Year, who will also be at that ceremony on the 1st of June. And I think, if I'm correct, and you'll probably be saying this again later this evening, Fraser, I think tickets are now available for that, and I'm sure you'll give a plug to it at the end on the 1st of June. Anyway, we are future-looking. We are an organisation that doesn't live in the past. We harness what was good from the past, and we want to do even better. And one of the things that we will benefit from in 22 into 23, with that development, that the enterprise option is available through the Young Persons Guarantee, we will have huge support from the DYW, the Developing Young Workforce Network, across the Southwest, to encourage young people to participate within our programmes. And over the course of the next coming weeks, you'll see a lot of communication around about the company programme and the team programme and other offerings as well, that will all be listed on the Young Persons Guarantee website, and you'll be able to route young people and their schools through to us at Young Enterprise Scotland if they wish to take part in the company programme, the team programme, or any other of the offerings that are available through the Young Persons Guarantee. Not just Young Enterprise Scotland activities, but a whole raft of opportunities for young people wishing to participate in enterprise. Fraser has been busy with his team at Young Enterprise Scotland, and he's going to tell you about some of the other initiatives that are going to be coming down the track for teaching staff, for volunteers, and for the young people themselves.
That's right, Geoff. We've got some really exciting initiatives coming your way for schools all across Scotland to make sure that we're providing as high a quality, impactful experience for young people as we possibly can for curricular year 22-23. So at the heart of the programme is the teaching staff all across the country who are involved in helping facilitate this programme with their young people. And to make sure that they are supported as best as they possibly can, we've set up a new CPD teaching resource for brand new teachers who are doing it for the very first time, and for teachers who have been doing it for many, many years. And we know, and we're very, very grateful for all those teachers who year after year come back and are involved in the company programme. And that's going to look like peer mentoring support, sessions and introductory about what enterprise means, how to help embed it in your school, maximising the impact of the programme in your school, and sharing best practice and reflecting on the skills that you as a practitioner are developing whilst facilitating the programme, because it's just as important as the young people's skills development as well. Now, without volunteers, we would not be the organisation that we are today, and we've got over 300 volunteers right across the country who are working as business advisors directly in the schools. And they meet with the schools on a weekly basis, whether that be in person or virtual, depending on the school and the individual. And what we're really keen to have for those is a mentoring opportunity, so that those volunteers are able to work with kind of peer support, people who have more experience. We've got some volunteers who are 20 plus years of experience of working with schools across the country, and we like to celebrate those every year with our Volunteer Long Service Awards, which will be also be taking place on Wednesday the 1st of June. So we've got a brand new mentorship program and induction and onboarding available for brand new volunteers for next year. And lastly, not forgetting the young people right at the heart of the program. To make sure that regardless of where you are in the country, you're getting access to the best quality training that we can possibly provide, we've partnered up with some of our national partners, the World Bank of Scotland, the Institute of Directors Scotland, the Institute of Chartered Accountants Scotland, the Marketing Society for Scotland, and many, many others, to create a brand new online training portal. And that's going to give those young people, regardless of where they are, access to video content that they can use whenever they want on the programme, which hopefully will be ready to launch in just a few weeks, just after the Scottish finals, so that young people can tap into that expert knowledge at the time that they need it most, to make sure that they're maximising the most they possibly can get as part of that skills development programme through the company or team programme. But to ensure this is possible, we have to make sure there's a structure in place to help support that, which Geoff is going to tell you a little bit more about now.
Yeah, thank you very much, Fraser. And one of the things that we mentioned earlier in tonight's presentation was the fact that financial education is now a key part of Young Enterprise Scotland. And last year we acquired another charity working in that space called the Stuart Ivory Financial Education Trust. And we've been working behind the scenes to integrate the resources from the Stuart Ivory Financial Education Trust. And we are currently creating a number of roles, in fact, a total of five roles that will work across the six regional improvement collaboratives to support our financial and enterprise education activities. So over the course of the coming weeks and months, we will be letting you know across the Southwest who's going to be your key contact, who's going to be supporting that activity. And so this is that's why we've set out and we're having these sessions, and we're delighted to be with you in the Southwest this evening. We saved the best for second on the series of six. All the others we can forget about. We were in the West on Tuesday, and we've got another three or four to do in the next couple of weeks. So there'll be a watch for the announcement about a key contact who will be here, there and everywhere to support you as volunteers, to support you as teachers in the school, to make sure that we have even greater coverage and impact next year in 22 into 23. And we've got one big announcement to save, and I always give the big announcements to Fraser because he can smile much more than me when he says these next few words. Over to you, Fraser.
Well, we're delighted that as part of our 30th anniversary this year, that usually the registration fee for the company and team programme is £100, and that helps cover the insurance for the team's access to all of the resources and the fantastic training that's available through the programme. But this year, for our 30th anniversary, we are delighted to announce that we will be reducing that registration fee to £30 as part of our 30 for 30 campaign, to make sure that young people across the country are able to access and get involved with as few barriers as possible. So we're delighted, and teams that are ready to sign up, I'm sure across the country will be delighted to hear that news, that they can invest all of that extra cash that they have saved directly into their businesses that they're creating at the start of next year.
Thank you very much, Fraser. And it's far more than a buy one, get one free. I don't know what the terminology is. It's pretty much, it's more than buy one, get two free. So if Stranraer Academy are watching and they paid £100 last year, it means that actually they could have three companies trading out of Stranraer Academy next year for exactly the same price. So we're delighted with that. And I'd really like to pay tribute and thanks to all the team from Young Persons Guarantee at the Scottish Government for throwing their weight and support and partnership behind us with this series of events to make it happen, for sharing it through the Developing Young Workforce networks. We're going to call it, as they say in the television land or the film land, we're going to call it a wrap very, very soon. Just before we go, a huge thanks to the team at Young Enterprise Scotland. That's Fraser here and Carly, who's in the back room, making sure all this happens properly. Huge thank you to all the volunteers around the Southwest region. A huge thank you to all the teaching staff who support us, the centre leads, and a huge thanks to all the young people who have participated last year in the Southwest region. We look forward to seeing you more. And anybody who is looking for more information, it will flash up along the front of your screen. Please get in touch with us. There's a couple of email addresses for regard to the team programme, teamprogramme@yes.org.uk. And company program at yes.org.uk. And I see, just before we go, I see a questionnaire from Jane Cameron. I think it's in the public domain there. I will come back to you, Jane, with regard to the Ayrshire Ladder of Enterprise, and let's see how we can develop that with your local chair, Stephen, and others. So I will be in touch directly after, probably tomorrow. I'm going to will not do it this evening. So thank you very much for joining us on this live broadcast. To all the people, please be free to share it with your friends, contacts, and let's see how big we can grow the team program, the company program, and other enterprise offerings across the Southwest Regional Improvement Collaborative. Have a lovely evening, and we'll stay in touch. Thank you very much.